Dear students, good morning and welcome to lecture number 4 in chapter 11. As you know, you have already attended 3 lectures in chapter number 11, where we studied about structure of eye. We studied about defects of vision in detail. Okay. We studied about refraction through prism. 3 topics we studied in detail. Understood? And as far as the refraction through prism concerns, we have studied how the dispersion of white light takes place and forms the 7 color. Spectrum of 7 color, and at the same time you are also guided that based on this phenomenon of dispersion of light or splitting of light into 7 color, one natural phenomenon is observed in nature. That natural phenomenon we call rainbow, and we explained you that how rainbow take place. Every water droplets present in the cloud behaves as a prism, and as a result you are able to see a band of 7 color in the sky. Almost 7 to nahi, but we are able to see that. So that rainbow formation is ultimately one type of refraction and the natural phenomenon observed on account of refraction. Now today, almost today in lecture number 4, our target is to study some natural spectacular phenomenon based on one topic which I titled here, atmospheric refraction. If somebody asks you what is refraction, not a new word for us. Understand, refraction you all know, when light ray pass, don't concentrate on these 2 diagram I have drawn to save our time. Okay, anya dhyan apo. If somebody asks you what is refraction, so your mind is quite clear. And you all know that whenever light ray passes from one transparent medium to another, it bends. Understand, that is called refraction. And it occurs. Why the refraction takes place? Because 2 transparent medium are never equally optically denser. There is some difference in their optical density, as you all know. One medium may have less optical density, we call it optically rarer medium. Other transparent medium may have more optical density, that we call it optically denser medium. And you are also given an idea about so many so many mediums consisting different optical density, like light, take an example, glass, water, diamond, kerosene. We already have discussed. Today our target is to understand this particular word, atmospheric refraction. Question may arise in your mind that, sir, we know refraction very well, that it occurs when light ray pass from one transparent medium to another. But let me clarify the meaning of atmospheric refraction. Actually, before we study some phenomenon which take place due to atmospheric refraction, let me explain you why atmospheric refraction take place. Word itself implies the meaning of this. Atmospheric refraction means refraction has to take place in atmosphere. My dear student, you all know that our earth is surrounded by a thin layer of atmosphere. Now that thin layer of atmosphere which is enveloping our earth, that atmosphere means different layers of air. If we just concentrate, suppose, just do not concentrate on this, concentrate on this diagram. Suppose we just draw our earth. Earth is not perfectly spherical, we all know, but just understand. Suppose our earth surrounded by a thin layer of atmosphere. Okay, a thin layer of atmosphere surrounds our earth. Now these layers of air are not equally optically denser or rarer. Actually, what happens? Okay, suppose this is atmosphere. Now if you travel from Earth's surface upward, what happens? You must have heard the word that as you go on higher altitude, air becomes thinner. You all know. So obviously the air near the earth's surface is thicker. So as you move away from earth, what happens? Initially the layer of the air is thicker. Then as you move away from earth, the air becomes thinner and thinner. That means, suppose I draw, just for understanding, suppose, just concentrate here. Suppose I have drawn three layers of air here, suppose. First layer near to the earth, then away from earth, then away from earth. So what happens? This is thicker layer. Compared to this, this is thinner. Compared to this, this is thinner. So actually what happens? As you move away from earth, the layer of air becomes rarer and rarer. Understand? Layer of earth near the earth's surface is obviously thicker. But as you move away, the layer of the air becomes thinner, thinner, thinner and thinner. So you can understand that as the air layer becomes thinner and thinner, what happens to the refractive index? It decreases. Dhyan ma chhe na? Refractive index directly depends on optical density of the medium. So just try to think, the air layer at the top is quite thinner, so it has less refractive index. Come below, air layer has more refractive index. Come beneath, air layer has more refractive index. That means if you move away from earth and travel through different layers of air, refractive index decreases. Samjhet ne? Thicker, thinner, thinner, thinner. So as you move away from earth, What happens to the various layers of air? Refractive index decreases. Think contradictory. If you move from top layers of air towards earth, then what happens? Air layer become thicker and thicker. That means refractive index increases. Barabar dhyan apo. They have written sentences in the textbook. You should be very clear. Going up, refractive index decreases. Moving down, refractive index increases. Because thicker to thinner, thinner to thicker. Understand? So, atmospheric refraction, before we discuss, I must want to make clear, atmospheric refraction occurs on account of different layers of air which possess different optical density. So when light ray passes through different layers of air, it refracts. Understand? Whenever it passes through different layers of air, it is going to refract. You particularly, you must have seen also, suppose you are standing somewhere and you see some warm, turbulent flow of air rising up. Suppose you are standing in front of fire and hot air is coming out of that. Try to visualize object through that turbulent hot layer of air. It looks like the object behind, you see some flickering or some wavering of the image of the object. That is also one example of atmospheric refraction, because the air which is just above the fire is obviously hotter than the air little up. So two layers of air are already there. So there is going to be atmospheric refraction. So dear student, try to understand. Atmospheric refraction take place because different layers of atmosphere are there, different layers of air possess different density. Now let us try to understand why. Now we concentrate. First I explain you why atmospheric refraction take place. Suppose in exam they just ask, explain atmospheric refraction, so your mind has to be quite clear about atmospheric refraction. It has to be very clear in your mind. Okay, why atmospheric refraction take place? What is the condition of the thin layer of atmosphere? What is the condition of different layers of air? That needs to be very clear in your mind. Understood? Now, let us try to study why it happens that whenever you try to see or visualize, observe any star at night, it looks like if you constantly stare at one star, it looks like the light emanating from the star, understand, is fluctuating. It looks like, we call it twinkling of star. Why it happens? Why twinkling of star happens? Actually, is it real position? Do twinkling of star real take place, or we, our eye experience it? So obviously the answer is no. Actually star never twinkled. Then our sun is also one of the star, will start twinkling. Okay, star does not twinkle, it looks twinkle. Twinkling of star, understand, not only that, if you constantly stare at the star quite away from us, so sometimes the position of the star also look little fluctuating from its original position. Means the real position you are not able to visualize. You are able to visualize some apparent position of the star. And that apparent position also looks little wavy. because the atmospheric refraction condition are not stationary. The thickness of the air layer also sometimes varies in different season. Okay, so now what happens? Try to understand. Before I explain you why the star twinkle, understand, I want to explain you one thing if you can remember. Suppose two layers of air are there, suppose medium 1 and medium 2. Suppose this is optically, I am just writing R, rarer medium, and suppose I am writing here D, denser medium. Can anybody remember when light ray passes from rarer medium to denser medium, what happens? It will not continue its original path, but it bends towards normal. So we all know that whenever light ray passes from rarer to denser medium, it bends towards normal. Same phenomenon observed here. See, I have written O. O means the position of observer. Try to understand. And actually this is star, quite away from you. Star, as you know, can be considered a point source of light. I have drawn here just to make you understand three layers of air only. 1, 2, 3. Obviously the top layer ke vase, understood? This will be thinner. Then compared to this, this is thicker. Compared to this, this is thicker. So what happens? Light ray while traveling through three layers of air, layer 1, 2 and 3, obviously when it travels from one layer to another, what happens? It is going from rarer to denser, rarer to denser. Whenever light ray pass from rarer to denser medium, it bends towards the normal. So what happens? Light ray. See, I have just drawn one light ray here, emanating from star, this layer. This is the interface separating two media. It has to go this way, but because it traveled from rarer to denser, see, it bends towards normal. Again, comparing these two layers, it has to travel from rarer to denser, it still bends towards normal. Again, when it emerges out, it bends towards normal. So actually, light from star does not straight enters into your eye. Understand? But it passes through different layers of air and bends again and again. Suppose I have drawn three layers, so it bends four times and then it enters your eye. So when light enters your eye, if you extend this ray, actually you see the star. This is the apparent position of the star and this is the real position of the star. When you visualize or stare at the star in the sky, it looks here rather than here. Understand? Not only it looks here, because I told you that atmospheric refractive condition are not stationary, so little fluctuation also take place. Not only that, so the apparent position of the star is obviously away, little shifted from the real position. Not only that, because light travels through different layers of air and it bends again and again, understand, it looks like that the intensity of light goes on decreasing again and again. Understand? Means there may occur some variation in the intensity of the light emanating from the star. So you are not feeling a stable light. When you stare at the star, it looks like that the intensity of light is also little varying, which we call twinkling of star. So we are calling it a twinkling of stars. So this is one of the phenomenon occurring due to atmospheric refraction. Okay, so twinkling of star can take place due to atmospheric refraction only. Not only twinkling of star take place but the apparent position of the star is little away from the real position of the star. And not only that, the light emerging from the star also looks with varying intensity. And that's why you utilize the word that the star twinkles at night. Actually, it is not the fact. It happens only due to atmospheric refraction. Understand? So this has to be very clear in your mind. Why twinkling of star take place? And this must, you have to make it very clear. Different layers of air and light ray bends towards normal and enter your eye, and you see the real position of the star somewhere shifted from the real position. And it happens because the star which you stare at night are quite away from us. So light has to travel a long distance before entering your eye. Understand? First is travel in space, then it enters our atmosphere, and then it reaches to our eye. So traveling such a long distance and suffering from atmospheric refraction through different layers of air give rise to this phenomenon of twinkling of star. Understand? So this phenomenon of atmospheric refraction is clear. Not only that, one another phenomenon we want to understand is early sunrise and delayed sunset. You must have seen that early sunrise and delayed sunset, almost the difference of 2 minutes. Understand? Now try to understand this phenomenon. Actually, what happens? First, you have to understand the word horizon. I have written H for this. What does it mean? Suppose this is our earth and you are standing here. So horizon means what? So up to the limit of your eyesight, what you can see, the boundary of the earth which you can visualize. Understand? Horizon, which in some time we also utilize in Hindi, we were utilize kshitij. That means the horizon. What does it mean? Suppose you are standing near some sea coast and you try to extend your eyesight up to the limit. Understand? So you are able to see a limited. Because our eye vision is also, it is called that eye vision is infinite, but infinite doesn't mean that it has no limit. So up to some extent you are able to visualize some line. Understand? So that at a visual line, understand, which you are thinking as horizon. And you think like some, when sun rises, sun is coming out from horizon, and when it set, it is going below horizon. Actually, horizon is an imaginary boundary of the earth we are thinking. Actually, it does not exist. Understand? So horizon means what? And wherever you are standing and up to the limit, you are able to just mark a line in front of you. That's called horizon. So now what happens? Suppose I am observer here, and this is horizon for me. This imaginary line, understand, I can extend my eyesight, becomes horizon for me. So these are the apparent position of the sun. Suppose at sunrise, what happens? You all know at sunrise what is going to happen, and you all know the movement of the sun: north, south, east, west. Sun, understand, we call it rises in the east and set in the west. So this can be the movement of the sun. Sun, so this is the movement of the sun. Okay, so now what happens? Actually, we are able to visualize sun 2 minutes before the sunrise. So before the sun come out from this horizon and becomes visual to us, the ray of light coming from sun, understand, bends and enter our eye, and we are able to visualize sun 2 minutes before the actual sunrise. Understand? Why it happens? As I told, exactly opposite to this. Here the light ray will bend away from near normal, here towards normal. So the light ray enters up, travel through atmosphere and bends and enter your eye. Understand? This is normal, suppose. So it bends away from normal and enter your eye, and you are able to visualize the sun 2 minutes before the sunrise. The same thing when the sun set, suppose the sun set at a sunny moment, suppose from here to here. So when sun sets, even sun has set, you are able to visualize sun due to atmospheric refraction. So it looks like even sun has gone beyond horizon. Understand, it is visualized, it is, you are able to visualize it. So you can say that actual sunset also occurs 2 minutes late, delayed sunset. Understand? So 2 minutes earlier sunrise and 2 minutes delayed sunset occurs on account of this phenomenon which you call atmospheric refraction. This has to be very clear in your mind. In exam, if they ask, write a short note on atmospheric refraction. I'll give the homework today also. So you have to give some glimpse, some aspects of atmospheric refraction. Then you have to explain why twinkling of star take place. At the same time, you also have to explain reason for early sunrise and delayed sunset. You have to produce the reason for that. Understand? Sometime in exam they ask separately also. Okay, why twinkling of star take place? What is the reason for early sunrise and delayed sunset? That also you can explain. Okay, so topic of atmospheric refraction. And now, you must have understood this. And now, today, we are taking the last topic. As I erase material from this board, you should revise the topic we have studied just now and concentrate on those topics. Now we are taking a very small topic, not so large topic. Okay, that is scattering of light. Refraction of light throughout the chapter we have studied. And now I want to highlight one another word, that is last topic in this chapter, and that is called scattering. Scattering of light. Refraction of light we studied. But now we have to study the scattering of light. The very first thing I must explain you is that what is actually the meaning of scattering of light. I must remind you somewhat regarding, if you can remember, Tyndall effect, which you must have studied in 9th standard. Just try to understand. Actually, when scattering of light take place, so whenever light struck on any minute particle, the scattering of light take place. It is like you take some water in glass and pour it from height, and when it falls, it scatters. So similar phenomenon occurs in nature, scattering of light. Whenever light passes through different layers of air, it struck minute air particle, because our air is a mixture of so many things. Understand, air contain water, air contains tiny water droplets, some fog particles, smog particles, air molecules, so many things. So when light ray passes from air, it struck on these minute particles present in the air, and the light gets scattered. Understood? And light actually becomes visible due to scattering only. Tyndall effect, we all know, if you can remember, if you can understand, suppose this is true solution. Yachana, true solution, and suppose this is colloidal solution. What happens? If you allow light ray to pass through this, no scattering take place, because solute particles are so smaller, understand, that they are not able to scatter the light in a dark room. But if you allow light to pass through colloidal solution in a dark room, so actually colloid particle are at least bigger than the solute particle in true solution, and they are able to scatter the light. And in dark room you can see the scattering of light, which we call Tyndall effect. Understand? So Tyndall effect you all know, and you have also experienced, or you heard, that if in a smoky room, understand, you allow a beam of light to fall, you are able to visualize so many aerosol particle present in air. You will see it becomes, you are able to visualize it, because minute particle present even in smoke, understand, they scatter the light. So light scattering take place. Even you have seen that whenever a light passes through canopy of forest, we are able to visualize the beam of light because of that scattering. Understand? So scattering of light take place in atmosphere also. And because scattering of light take place in atmosphere, understand why it take place, that I already told you. And you all know that the light, white light, is made up of 7 colors. If you just divide it, just take an example. Suppose we just write with your understand. Just try to you can consider this a blue horizon. Lagbhag evu j hoy ne, violet, indigo, blue, green. Lagbhag ane at least up to this can be considered a red horizon. Now what happens? Try to understand it. When light passes through different layers of air, means when it passes through air, if size of the air molecule is quite less than even the wavelength of the visible light. What is the wavelength of visible light? You almost know. Badane yaad hase, it is already given in 100 to 4000 angstrom. You all know. So if the air particle size of, means diameter of the air particle, is even smaller than the wavelength of the visible light, so what happens? Okay, when light falls or travels through air, it is scattered, and because the size of the particle is quite smaller, it scatter the light near blue more than the light near red. Because if the particle are quite smaller, so it will definitely scatter this light more and this light less. So what happens? Okay, because on account of this only, the sky appears blue. Otherwise, there is no physical existence of sky. It is not like a plate, we can touch it. Actually, the sky looks blue to us on account of scattering of the light, and minute air particles scatter light near blue more than the light near red. So it doesn't, I never mean to say that it does not, it will not scatter red light also. It scatter, but it scatter this blue light more than the red. That's why the sky looks bluish. Understand? That's why we call the beautiful blue sky exist on us. Actually, if astronaut or if are traveling in space, are they able to visualize the blue color of the sky? Never. They visualize the sky as a dark only because no scattering of light take place there. Okay, that's why the color of the sky looks bluish. Not only that, my dear student, and remember one thing: size of the particle. Suppose I draw three particles. Smaller particle, it will scatter blue light more. Little bigger particle, it will scatter red light more. And even bigger than that, then it will scatter all light and it looks white. Here red and here blue. Okay, actually we are going to study this. Now what happens? So you understood the scattering of light quite clear in your mind. Understand the Tyndall effect, you already know. And a sky looks blue on account of the scattering of light only. Not only that, I must explain one thing. Why it happens that during sunrise or sunset, the sky looks reddish, reddening of the sun and sky, orange reddish color, which we call crimson red color. Why it happens? Because, just try to understand. Suppose this is Earth. And you are observer here. Suppose you are here. Now when the sun is overhead here, this is sun, the light from the sun travel a very short distance to reach your eye. So at noon the sun looks whitish. But what happens that during sunrise or sunset, I just draw the position of the sun here somewhere. Similar position here. What happens during sunrise or sunset? Try to understand. Light from sun travel a long distance and enter our eye. And while traveling this long distance, it traveled through atmosphere. And atmosphere is full of, because it travel a good distance, long distance, the particle present in the atmosphere scatters. So you all know that the minute particles scatter which light? Blue. So what happens? The seven color means white color from sun, understand, made up of seven color. Out of that, before the light reaches to our eye, most of the blue section has been scattered away. So the light when enters your eye consisting of maximum portion of yellow, orange, red. Understand? So what happened? The sky and sun looks crimson red color. That is on account of one type of scattering of light only. Understand? So this is clear. Even the same thing occurs during sunrise, because light has to travel a long distance before entering your eye. So scattering take place here also. Scattering take place here also. And during scattering, because the air is full of minute particle, it scatters all blue light. Because the blue light is scattered away, so the only visible light becomes are red, orange and mixture of that. That's why we call it crimson red color. It is not the exact red, understand? So this happens on account of scattering of light only, right? So my dear student, you understood why. If you have seen, even in Bhavnagri, try to understand. Suppose some residential multi-storied building are there. They put their board with red lights. Why? Because red is scattered less. So now you understood. Okay, why you see some signing board at the top of the building, understand, are made up of red. Actually, they contain the red LED. Because red light is always scattered less and becomes visual from a long distance. from a long distance it become visual to us, understand? So mostly traffic signals are also made up of red illuminating light. Why? Because it is scattered less by the air molecules and it becomes visualized to you from a long distance. You are able to observe and visualize it, understand? So this is the topic of scattering of light. Mostly we wanted to cover two topics today. One is atmospheric refraction and one is scattering of light. Okay, so before I deliver homework to you for today's lecture, let me remind you that this chapter with this is over. We have covered two topics today, atmospheric refraction, and then we have studied scattering of light, where we studied Tyndall effect, and at the same time I explained you why the sky appears blue and why the sky and the sun appears crimson red, understand, during sunrise and sunset, because of scattering of light only. Okay, so before we end, the homework for today's lecture, note down first. First question. Emma, we will mix 2 to 3 questions, alright? Explain atmospheric refraction. Note it down. Explain atmospheric refraction. Emma Dagar, move ahead. Why star twinkle at night? Emma Dagar, what is the reason for early sunrise and delayed sunset? It's a set of 3 questions. Explain atmospheric refraction. Why star, what is the reason for twinkling of star, means why star twinkle at night? And the third one, understand, that is what is the reason for early sunrise and delayed sunset? Question number 2. Explain scattering of light. Explain scattering of light. Move ahead in the same. Explain Tyndall effect. Move ahead in the same. What is the reason for the bluish color of the sky? Means you can modify that way. Why sky looks bluish? Understand? And next, Emma Jagar, why sun and the sky looks reddish during sunrise and sunset? Should I repeat? Why sun and the sky appears reddish during sunrise and sunset? So you can explain it. That is also one account of scattering of light also. Understand? So this many two questions. One, first is a set of 3 questions. Second is a set of again 4 questions. Okay. So complete this homework. Read from material also of online textbook. If you have downloaded, read from that also. Sufficient material. And we have explained you thoroughly both the topic, atmospheric refraction and scattering of light. Okay. Thank you for attending today's lecture. Okay. Thank you very much from Bharat Swami.